Hello, ATs, receiving students and receiving teachers. Thank you, take your seat. Okay, before we go into our lesson for today, I'd like us to recap what we have learned in our previous lesson. What did we learn in our previous lesson? Can I have Benjamin? Benjamin, please, can you tell the class what you have learned or what we have learned in our previous lesson? Receiving students, I'd like you to do the same thing. Okay. Let's listen from Benjamin.
Arranging of data.
Good. Arranging of data in what?
Tables.
Okay. In our previous lesson, we looked at arranging data in the table. Very good. Our today's lesson, we will look at another way that data can be organized, and that is graph. I hope in your previous lesson you have looked at some of, in grade 7 you have covered some common types of graph. But before we go any further, I'd like to introduce the strand and substrand and the topic. So our strand for today is change and data, substrand statistics, learning outcome, interpret information presented statistically, lesson objective, and the lesson topic is organizing data in graphs. Another effective way of organizing data in graph or organizing presenting data in statistics is by using graphs. Now, there are different types of graphs. Some of these graphs I hope you have covered in your in grade 7. So these graphs, there are different types of graphs that data can be presented in, and these different types of graphs are used for different purpose of data, different data. Not all data are used for the same different types of graphs. Some graphs, data is presented in them in different ways. So they are used for different purposes. So before we go on to our today's lesson, I would like to show you some examples of data. Some examples of graphs that data can be presented in. Let us view some examples of these graphs. As we go through, I will show you from the screen. Okay, types of graphs. Column graph is one of those types of graphs that data can be presented. It's a type of graph that you can present your data. We have the next type of graph, which is bar graph. Bar graph and column graph can be used for same data. Okay, whatever information that you put in column graph, you can also present it in bar graph. So they are mainly used for presenting numerical data. Numerical data, you can present them in bar graph and column graph. When you are presenting data in bar graph and column graph, make note of the following points. Okay, there are following points which are shown there. All bars must be of the same width. And you must leave a space between each bar. So these are some things that you must make note of when you are presenting or putting data, organizing data in bar graph and column graph. We have the next type of graph, which is called sector graph, or sometimes they call it pie graph or pie chart. data that is presented in sector graph is always given in percentage. Not like the other graphs, column graph and bar graph, which is data presented is in numerical. We have the next type of graph, which is frequency histogram. Frequency histogram is another type of graph that statistics or data can be presented in. Okay, and frequency histogram is used for numerical data. Any numerical data, you can present them in histogram, frequency histogram, or this type of data. So these are some of the common types of graphs. There are other graphs which are not being shown here, like line graph. Line graph is another type of graph. Okay, time graph is also another type of graph. Time graph you have covered in your previous lesson on the topic or on the lesson on time. These are also examples, some examples of graphs. So I would like us to look on the board. Our previous lesson, we used this data and we organized this data in a frequency table. That was in our previous lesson. Now we are going to use this same data and put it in or present it in a column graph. So our activity for today, we will try to present this data which has been given in table. We will try to present it in a column graph. So that will be our activity for today, to understand how we can organize data in a in graphs. So we are going to use one type of graph, which is column graph, to organize the data. Receiving students and receiving teachers, our activity will be organizing data in a column graph. The strategy that we will be using is group work. So in our group work, in our groups, we will try to organize data in a graph. Okay, that is our activity for today. We will try to use the data from the table. Okay, like I've said, this table, or it's also on the PowerPoint. The same information which I've shown on the board is also on the screen. So we are going to use the data which is given from the table there. We will use that data and draw a column graph using the data which have been given in a frequency table. So I would like the runners to come up to the front and collect the materials for the group. Each group will be given. Can I get one each? Get a ruler, one ruler. And then get this one. One each. Okay, I'll once again repeat the activity for the sake of the receiving students. Use the data from the table and draw a column graph. Okay, the data is on the table there. You will use the table to draw a column graph. Receiving students and ATs, I'd like to have your attention. I will show you an example of how you should have your data, or how you should draw a column graph. Okay, I'll give you an example. Okay, from the screen you will see an example of how you should draw your column graph. So make note of what things that you should have in your column graph. The example on the screen will give you some ideas on how you can prepare or draw up your column graph. So use that idea from the example from the screen and try to use the information given from the table to draw a column graph. You may start now. Remember, you are using the data from the table. So try to use the information from the table. You draw up a column graph. Okay, I've given you an example of how you should draw a column graph. What information you should have on the column graph. Yes. You should use pencil first. Let me see. Oh, this is the last one. Oh, drawing a box. That's okay. Drawing a box again. Use this one. Use this one. That's okay. The information from me. Sorry, putting it in.
Use this door so you can I call your name, you come up, and your task is to draw this line nearby. It's already been prepared there. It's already, all you got to do is get the ruler, marker, and then just draw that bar.
Make a good proper sketch.
That is untidy. Okay. This group have finished this. See what this group has done. Okay. Simon, please, can you show the class what you have done? Face the camera. Show the class what you have done. Face the camera. Okay, this group, that's what this group has done. They have used the information from the table and transferred it into a column graph presented there. So you other group should be doing something like that. Thank you, Simon. Finish. Okay. Group 4, you can paste yours up here. Those others who have finished, you can bring yours up to the board and paste it up here. Katrina, come. Just one. Finish, huh? Okay, paste it up. That's okay. It doesn't matter. As long as you have done something. It doesn't mean untidy, it doesn't matter. You should think of that. That was one of the requirements. That's okay. Okay. Up on the board. Peggy, you say one name number by right name. Okay. Silas. Peggy, Silas. Priscilla. Mitchell. Martha. And what's your name again? Maybelline. Hey, students. We have some few minutes remaining, so I'd like this remaining few minutes, we will do our corrections. Okay, we will do correct our activity. In our correction, I have a chart here. I will select few students who will come up to the board and will fill in this chart with the information that is from the table. So I'd like the following students are Mitchell, Silas, Martha, Priscilla, Barbara, and Peggy to come up to the front. Please bring your markers as well. Come to the front. The following students whom I call your names, please. Can you come to the front? Okay, ruler here. Okay, we will start off from Silas. Silas. And oh, six. Roll the line, fill in the bar. Thank you, Silas. Take your seat. Okay. Silas will do, Mitchell will. Number two. Okay, let's have who's number three? Peggy. Bring the ruler here. Who's doing number four? Okay, five. Okay, thank you, Peggy. Down. Yeah. That's it. Okay. Thank you, Barbara. Let's have a Mata. Let's have. Is it okay? Just go over it again. Over it again. Low one. Thank you. Now, receiving students and ATs, I'd like you to compare what your friends have just done. Compare this with your work and see what things that you missed. This is what your friends have done. If you look at this example, you will see that this column graph has a title. Some of your column graph doesn't have a title. You can see some of these examples here. They don't have a title. And the spacing is very important. Remember, when you are drawing a column graph, presenting data, or drawing a column graph, you must have equal spacing. And the bars must be of the same width. So look at some of these examples. You will see that some of the bars are not the same width. Some are big and some are small. So it is very important, spacing of bars and the size of the bar must be considered, and informations like what information should go vertically and what information should go horizontally. Okay, always the frequency in a column graph, frequency is always vertical, and the number of scores is always horizontal. So that brings us to the end of the lesson, receiving students. Before we end the lesson, receiving teacher, tell your students your additional activity is on the screen. For more additional activity, refer to Secondary School Mathematics 8B. Pages are given there, receiving teacher. That brings us to the end of our lesson, and our key phrase for today is data in graphs. Thank you, students. This has brought us to the end of the lesson. I hope to see you again in the next lesson. Thank you for your participation. Thank you.